Alright, so it is 5:59, well, 6 p.m. here on the East Coast, and it's just a matter of hours until we see the new Nintendo Direct for January 2015, and it's going to be crazy because there's a whole lot of expectations going on out there, so I wanted to make a couple of videos before the live stream happens, before Nintendo blows us all away, so that way we can kind of get our ideas in motion. Now, this video is going to be focused just on what I'm excited to see, my expectations, and then we're also going to read through the YouTube comments of my Nintendo Direct video, the initial one I posted 17 hours ago, and we'll see what some of you guys are saying in terms of the hype that you want, or the games that you want, rather, to see at the Direct when it happens at 6 a.m. Pacific Time and 9 a.m. Eastern Time. So, now, in terms of stuff that I'm excited about, one of the most obvious things is definitely going to be the new 3DS. It hasn't had an American release date announced yet, although it has popped up in Australia, popped up in Italy with a few release dates dropped here and there, but nothing really solid confirmed for America yet, so everyone's really anxious about it in terms of, you know, when are we going to see this? Is it going to be in March? Is it going to be in February? And right now, I'm hoping and praying to Allah that this thing is going to be dropped in February, because, I mean, at the end of the day here, even if you aren't getting a new 3DS game right away, the fact that this has ceased the compatibility with Smash, and if you still like using the 3DS controls like my ass, then this is going to be perfectly accommodating for you. And plus, you know, I'm not even going to lie, guys, like, when Xenoblade Chronicles comes out for the new 3DS, I'm going to be covering that. I really want to. It looks like an amazing game, and the fact that it's running on a handheld device, you can't really beat it, so I'm definitely excited for the new 3DS. That's something that, dog, like, that, I hope they announce an American release date for that right away, so that way we can get the big stuff out of the way, so, you know, we can move on to the Direct with already good things going. But then again, Nintendo knows how to organize these things. They know what to put out when, so that way people watch the entire Direct. So, you know, maybe, I'm predicting maybe that news will probably be put out maybe in the beginning, though, because they want something to grab people. And, you know, grabbing people with an American release date, or even a European release date to an extent, because I know a lot of European countries or, you know, places haven't really gotten an announcement date either for the new 3DS. So, yeah, that's going to be basically the biggest thing that everybody's looking forward to. So now, that was one of the things I'm most excited about. So let's see what some new comments are saying in terms of my video, because everybody's got their own idea in terms of what's happening. So, Herrick says, I personally hope they announce the new episode of Pokemon Ball Z. That's never gonna happen, but I mean, you know, very optimistic of you. Let's move down a little bit more. Max Rendon says, Roy for DLC. I doubt that's gonna happen too, but you know what? It's good to remain optimistic, I suppose. Lucy Daw says, I want Fire Emblem Wii U. And you know what? Lucy, you bring me to my next point. The next game that I'm really excited to see something about is a new Fire Emblem, whether it be for the new 3DS, the regular 3DS, or the Wii U. In fact, even though I know it would be somewhat of a bold move to put a great series like Fire Emblem on such a brand new console like the new 3DS, I'm hoping that after an American release date, they give us an Americanized release date for Fire Emblem, perhaps for the new 3DS. I don't know. I don't want them to piss off their fan base, because, you know, a lot of people would be upset if they put such an amazing title on a console that barely anyone's going to have yet, as I know there are a lot of you guys out there who bought a 3DS after, like, just a little bit of time before finding out that the new 3DS is coming out. And it kind of sucks, because if you blew all your money on getting your 3DS in the first place, there's no way you're going to be able to get yourself a new 3DS now. So I can understand a lot of the frustration that you guys have who fell victim to that, and I think it was a little bit messed up. Nintendo should have announced a while ago that they were making a new 3DS, but it just sucks. This is the way they market these things, man. It's really unfortunate, but I mean, like, but still, you have to understand that the new 3DS is one powerful console in terms of handheld power. That game, if it can fit Xenoblade Chronicles in its entirety, and I looked up myself how long that game is. Like, I've seen Let's Play parts going up to, like, part number fucking 136, so I mean, that just goes to show you. The new 3DS has got some power to it, so I mean, I would love to see a game like Fire Emblem really just come out and just stun us all. Because, you know, I mean, the characters in Fire Emblem are so lovable, so I mean, seeing them in a more pronounced, defined way, such as running on a console, you know, being able to see all the waifus' cakes in full HD, Who wouldn't want that? So, I mean, or even if it's not on a console, on a powerful handheld like the new 3DS, I can see a lot benefiting from that. And considering Fire Emblem has had a new awakening to the series, whereas now it has more fans than ever. And, you know, Awakening is such a strong game in the franchise. Like, it turned so many people who never even looked at Fire Emblem twice before into diehard Fire Emblem fans like myself. To be honest, Marth never interested me. He seems like a cool character from when Melee came out, but I mean, he never interested me. But as soon as Fire Emblem Awakening's Robin dropped into Smash Bros., I fell in love with the whole franchise in general. Or maybe I just fell in love with Awakening. But either way, I'm really hoping that in some form or fashion, a Fire Emblem sequel or another game in the series is announced for any of the consoles. Who cares where it's on? Because it's quite clear they know how to run that 3DS with that Fire Emblem, baby. So now, let's take a look at some of the YouTube comments some of you guys have been leaving for me. Etika, is there any way for you to watch the live stream after it's finished? Do you save them, or do you delete them afterwards? My friend, I am going to be saving the reaction that I have to the direct, uploading it to YouTube. So you'll be able to either see like maybe small compilations if the whole thing isn't too interesting, because usually I don't really upload the entire thing, because it's not like everything makes me lose my shit, only a couple of key things. But I mean, if you guys really want me to upload the entirety of my reaction, then by all means, I'll do so. It just is, you know, kind of a little bit, hey, it's just gonna be me just sitting here watching. So I mean, hey. But either way, now Francesco Ventura says, okay, I have five things. Smash Brothers DLC. And you know what? It's such an obvious thing. That's pretty much where everybody's going to be focused on. Even right here on my list, in terms of the stuff that I'm hype about, I have it right there. SSB DLC. That's all that people want. SSB DLC. Without that, this direct is going to be a lot more flat than what people want. You know, like, they have to make sure that in some form or fashion, DLC is discussed, whether it's Mewtwo, whether it's stages, whether it's something. Smash Brothers needs to be involved in the spotlight from now on, because that's pretty much Nintendo's juggernaut title right now. It's gotta be involved. And as much as Daddy Sakurai may be trying to say that, you know, he's trying to leave the game alone after Mewtwo, it's gotta be in the forefront all the time. Keep that shit relevant. Keep it on top. Daddy Sakurai, I know you're tired, but I mean, get a little bit of something in there, man. You gotta keep this game relevant. You gotta keep it fresh. It's hot right now. It is hot right now. And the last thing you want is something to go wrong with that. Car King says, holy crap, the direct is on my birthday. Oh man, well, you're gonna be finding out something new. Hopefully you get yourself a gift in terms of stuff that you want for Nintendo for 2015 being determined true in the direct. I really wanna see some more gameplay from Pokken Tournament. That's actually interesting. No one that I talked to mentioned anything about Pokken yet. So, I mean, it's gonna be a good move to see something like that happen. Let's see. You dumbass, Nintendo is in Japan. It's probably like 8 o'clock or some shit over there. And you know what? That also may be another reason, because everyone was complaining about, oh, Etika, do you have any idea why the direct is done so early? Which I don't, but I mean, like I'm saying, maybe they're translating it from Japanese to English and they're doing it on their time zone where it's the best for them. So I mean, hey, but then again, if you translate the time zones, if they're doing it at such a early time for us, then they gotta be doing it somewhat late for them. But hey, let's fast forward a little bit more through some of these comments. Dr. Kerbal says, why would I drink some coffee to wake up when the Lucas DLC reveal will make me scream? And he's got a damn good point. That's why I don't really mind waking up too early, because you definitely won't regret it, especially finding out some crazy information like that. And let's move down. I've Etika play through Sakura Spirit. There's a lot of stuff that I guess I should be playing through. And I'm sorry about that. That's my Facebook notifications thing. I'm just going to mute that. But alright, so now, like I just explained to you guys, the next big thing that I'm hype about was the Smash DLC. And the final thing that I'm hype about in terms of the Nintendo Direct, seeing some information that's going to make me scream, is anything about Xenoblade Chronicles X. Xenoblade Chronicles X is the spiritual successor to Xenoblade Chronicles, which is the game that Shulk debuted in. And if you see the trailer for Xenoblade Chronicles X, which was announced earlier last year, your jaw will drop. I didn't play any of Xenoblade at all. I literally looked at Shulk as if he was a stranger at first, because I didn't know where he came from. I didn't know who he was. I thought the guy was Australian, for crying out loud. So I had absolutely no prior knowledge about Shulk whatsoever. But something about his character was cool, And you know, so I was like, okay, you know what? I'm getting into the series late. But you know, 2015, new year, new me. No, I'm kidding. But I mean, 2015, right? Let me buy myself Xenoblade Chronicles for the new 3DS, play through that, and then let me buy Xenoblade Chronicles X for the Wii U, so that way, you know, I progress, you know, casually in these games, I get to see what's going on. The most I knew about Xenoblade Chronicles, the first game, is that it involves Shulk with this awesome-looking sword that has, you know, a long penis inside of it that blows up whenever Shulk gets excited about something, and yet, at the same time, something happens between then and Xenoblade Chronicles X that flips the fucking story on its goddamn head. Now, one thing I wanted to do is I wanted to watch through a little bit of the Xenoblade Chronicles X trailer with you guys, because if you haven't seen it already, then you don't know what you're missing out on. So let's search that up right now. Xenoblade Chronicles X trailer. What we're going to do right now is basically just look at the trailer that they revealed at E3 in 2014. So I know a lot of you guys have already seen this, but if you haven't seen this yet, then this is the reason why Xenoblade Chronicles is probably the thing that I'm the most excited for the direct, next to anything Smash Brothers related. Check this out. Another reason, and like I said in the previous video, another reason why I love this title so much is because it's so much like Phantasy Star. Look at this shit. Her Earth gets destroyed, yo. Look at this! This is like some Attack on Titan type shit! Fight for humanity! What happened to Shulk? This is what I don't understand! This shit, I mean, not to say that I don't like this. This looks amazing! Look at how amazing this is! The Earth is destroyed at this point! It's crazy, man! Oh shit! Wait a minute! I didn't get to see the entirety of this. Whoa! Alright, so there's one remnant of the old game that Shulk was in. That's one of his mans that rolls with him on his adventure. I don't know his name by heart, of course, because I didn't play the first, but I mean, because, like, that's why I was just sitting here, like, when I was like, okay, you know, Xenoblade Chronicles X, I'm expecting, you know, I'm really feeling it to be all over the trailer. But instead, you see this crazy post-apocalyptic Earth-type wildness looking like Phantasy Star. I'm like, what the fuck is going on? What the flippin' chicken is this? Like, so, I mean, the shit is crazy, guys. It's crazy. So, I mean, there's also some other stuff for Xenoblade Chronicles X as well, too. And I have to show you this as well, too, because it's an amazing... It's an amazing showcase of just how insane this game is, man. Like, good God. Oh my goodness. Alright, so what we're gonna do right now, we're going to search the other Xenoblade Chronicles X thing that happened at E3, which is basically the treehouse. So they played through a lot of Xenoblade Chronicles X in terms of the beginning, and they showed us what the game
hey
was like.
Welcome back to and Treehouse.
These guys are always funny. This guy's actually pretty good with the villager, but I mean, let's fast forward a little bit.
The annihilating the earth.
So, watch right a little bit of this, guys.
Yeah. Get a little bit of gameplay experience. We'll get through as much of it as we can.
Yeah, we just started from the title screen, and we're just going.
And so we're going to set some here? Of the we're going to set some of the story up too.
Okay.
Ethan, since you can actually translate all this stuff, I may ask you to jump in and summarize.
Sure.
Nihon, this guy.
I'm just going to set some of the Nihon? Story stage here.
Yeah.
At the start of the game, you're going to see a vast battle of these two warring alien species.
Yeah.
Unfortunately, they've kind of decided to have their big battle right over-ish, over Earth.
yeah.
you know, right on top of us.
Not so great for us.
It doesn't work out very well for us, no. So the two of them are warring. They are essentially annihilating the Earth as they're doing all of this. We do our best to fight back, and that's what you're going to see in this cutscene here.
Yeah.
We do our best to fight back. We build technology that helps us to try to, you know, step up to the battle with the aliens.
You hear how crazy this shit sounds?
It doesn't really help us a whole lot. And the Earth is... Well, you'll see what happens to the Earth. That's cool. But we're gonna put all of humanity into a series of arc ships and just take off. Leave the Earth behind. And that's where Xenoblade Chronicles is going to start off.
Yeah. It's you'll see as we get going here. But it gets pretty epic pretty quickly. So
it's already epic.
That's the thing. Epic. Like... Yeah. And you know, it's just such a fucking vast story.
What you're seeing right here is the first of the warring alien species deploying their armada. As you can see,
look how amazing this
looks. You're gonna see.
So that's the Earth, and those are the different alien species.
A lot of guys. That's a lot of alien action.
You're gonna see things go bad pretty quickly here. There's the other alien species coming in. There they are, fighting
it out.
That is insane, man.
Yeah, the art design on this game is incredible. I love the ship design. I love the robot
2054.
Design. Yeah.
So if you saw the subtitles, it said 2054 is when this shit happens.
Yeah, it's good.
I hope I'm dead by this time, because holy
shit. Taking a look
at
this game, people see it for the first time, and they're just like, whoa, you know, it really catches the eye. We'll see that more as we dig in.
Look at this shit.
Now, you can see the battle looks like it's going okay, but you're going to see some... impact on Earth. Okay, poor choice of words. You're gonna
Damn.
See.
Look at those explosions on the fucking planet, yo. Look at those explosions! Those are happening on the planet, taking out huge masses of land!
Yeah, there's just kind of a narration here.
Look at this!
Explaining what, you know, that Earth kind of was this chosen battlefield and that, you know, these two forces have converged, basically summing up some of the stuff you've already said. And that the.
Look at those explosions!
The forces of Earth, you know, got together to try this sort of grand escape plan.
It's our last ditch effort, basically,
right.
to get away from the battlefield, since we know there's no hope left for the Earth itself.
Yep.
And you can see, you're going to see our arc ships taking off.
Yep.
And then you're going to see the Earth blowing up.
Just like that, Earth is gone.
Well, there goes.
Earth is fucking gone.
Come by, everyone.
Yeah, so, you know, have a good day. Just lifting your spirits, get things off on the right now.
So, I mean, I want to leave it there. I don't want to, like, spoil you guys to everything, but, you know, it's not technically spoiling, because this is officially revealed information, not, like, leaks or anything, so technically, you should be on top of it, but, I mean, still, either way, guys, so, you know, that's what I'm the most hype about for the Direct. I'm hoping we get a lot more information. The character customization in this game is also crazy, too, so there's a lot to look forward to, man, but, I mean, so that's what your boy's hype about, but what are you guys hype about? I'm gonna read a few more comments before I send everything off, so, new Smash Wii U stages, of course, baby, of course. Fucking school, damn it, yeah, a lot of people are falling subject to that shit. In fact, why don't we move up now, and why don't we see what the top comments are so we can answer some big questions. And now, I did say that a gateway video was coming today, but the problem with that is that I bought this 5-hour energy. It didn't do shit. I was tired all day. Ugh. I don't know. Maybe I should drink more of it. I only drank half. Guess I should have. But, all right. And I have exams on that day. College day ends at 1 p.m. to 5 a.m. I'm British. I'm going to run home. Hello, everyone. This is Satoru Iwata from Nintendo. Today, I would like to present my dick directly to you. You know, that sounds like something Iwata would do. Please understand. And they're probably going to officially announce the release date of the N3DS. Yeah, so I mean, everyone's basically saying the same thing. Now, I'm going to be making another video in terms of an amazing leak slash... yeah, you know what? Call it a leak. An amazing leak that happened on 4chan that seems to be authentic. But, you know, see that in the other video, because there's too much stuff to talk about to fit both of those topics into one video. So, hey, I'll talk to you guys in a few hours when the Nintendo Direct begins. And remember, I'll be live streaming that on my Twitch channel as well. So, you know, come through to the Twitch and watch the shit go down, because it's going to be bananas. I would stream it to YouTube live streaming, but I mean, I don't know. I really got to work on it. I wish I could do both. Maybe I can. Either way, guys, I will talk to you in the next video. Take care of yourselves. And of course, as usual, please have yourself a damn good one.